Hi, everybody, and welcome to 8 to 12 Cheerful Chats with Maddie Carver. Today I have with me Brittany Gross, interior designer and sustainability manager with Voith and Mactavish Architects. Hi, Brittany.
Hey, Maddie. How are you?
I'm very good. Happy Hanukkah.
Thank you. You too. Very festive back there.
Yes, I'm all ready with my multiple menorahs.
Love it.
Well, Brittany, this is just going to be like a sweet and short little chat. And it's the first night of Hanukkah. Are you going to be doing anything special tonight?
I think tonight we're just going to light the candles. Nothing special. We're kind of saving it for the weekend. So.
Well, good. That's fun. Yeah, that's when the real partying can happen. Well, I'm going to start with a few little questions here. What is your favorite holiday memory from childhood?
Yeah, so I feel like growing up and celebrating Hanukkah, our memories are a little bit different. We didn't always have it for the holiday the way Christmas, you know, you're always home and you're always off with your family. And this year it's pretty early. Sometimes it's even earlier, like November. So things kind of change. So my favorite tradition is probably a little different. And it's actually has to do with school, because we were always in school for Hanukkah for the most part. So growing up every year in elementary school, I would say, while it's still age appropriate, my mom used to come and teach everyone in our class kind of the culture and story behind Hanukkah. And it was really cool because I was probably one of the only Jewish kids in most of my classes. So it was really fun to get to share my culture with other people. You know, we mostly talk about like, the food, and I feel like a lot of Judaism is about culture, so it was fun to get to share that. And my mom would also, we would play dreidel, which is like the little toy that you spin, and it's a game. And she would bring in little coins, so it's gelt, they're chocolate, so you know, kids love that. And you play for the gelt is the game of dreidel. And then we would also make edible dreidels. So I don't know if you've ever seen this, but you take a marshmallow and you stick a pretzel rod in the top, and then you glue a Hershey kiss to the bottom with frosting, and it becomes this edible dreidel. So it turned to be like the highlight of everyone's year. Like, when's Brittany's mom coming in to teach us about Hanukkah? Cause we got a bunch of good food. And so yeah, that was really fun.
Oh, I love that. I love that story. So you got kind of like maybe like a birthday celebration, and then so you got like a bonus set, like school celebration.
I actually didn't get the birthday because my birthday was in July. So I always felt kind of gypped about that. So Hanukkah was like my thing, you know?
Well, there you go. That worked out. That sounds so fun. Did you guys sing the dreidel song?
Probably not. No. My mom's not much of like a singer, so I can't see her leading the class and singing a song.
I love that song though. Food.
Yeah, I know.
My sister and I used to always, because my Aunt Kathy celebrated Hanukkah. And so on the first night of Hanukkah, we would always call her every year and sing, dreidel, 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 I made you out of clay. You know, and it was, I'm sure everybody knows so you'll need me to sing it, but.
Yeah, there's actually a lot of Hanukkah songs out there, so people don't know.
I love that.
Yeah, they don't play them on the radio, so.
Do you have any, I know that maybe I'm putting you on the spot, but do you have a Hanukkah song that you can remember that you like, or?
They're all so cheesy.
They're all.
I feel like growing up in Hebrew school, they used to just like make you sing them to the death. So I can't say that I do. If you ask me to sing it, I'm just not gonna be able to do that. So.
Okay, well, I'm gonna Google all of the Hanukkah songs and see which one I like.
There's one about latkes, lots of latkes. That's pretty silly. I mean, we mostly sing about like food or lighting the candles. So, yeah.
I love it. Well, I think all of the holidays right now are pretty darn cheesy. So I think we're all in the same boat. So do you have a favorite holiday recipe, Brittany?
Yeah, I do. So I make this only once a year because it's so time consuming. And I don't even think it's necessarily tied to Hanukkah, but it's the only time when we have the week off between Christmas and New Year. So even if it doesn't fall on Hanukkah, I always make this because I have the time to do it. But it's babka. Have you ever heard of it?
I've heard of it, but I've never had
it. Okay. So do you know what it is?
No.
Okay. It's a Jewish sweet bread, and it's braided, kind of like challah, how it's like a braided bread, but it's sweet, and you can fill
it. I love challah bread.
You do? So do you like sweet?
I'm shy. Yes. I have such a sweet tooth, so I know that I would love it.
Oh, I'll have to bring you some this year when I make it, because I'll make a bunch of loaves. But essentially, it's like you make the dough, and then you fill it, kind of like a cinnamon roll, how you would fill it with stuff. So I fill mine with like chocolate, crumble. It's like chocolate and butter and sugar, essentially. And when you make your own, you can stuff it as much as you want. Because sometimes when you get it out, I find it doesn't have enough chocolate. So I'll like double the chocolate and just stuff it because I love chocolate.
Then Brittany, you roll it up. I knew I really liked you a lot.
Yeah.
You're my kind of girl.
And then, so you roll it up like a cinnamon bun, but then you make two of those and you braid it together. So essentially when it's all done, you cut into it, it's like all these different layers of fluffy bread and chocolate. And then you top it with like a chocolate streusel. So like more chocolate, butter, and sugar. it's amazing. And I probably only make it once a year too, because if not, I would eat it like way too much of it. It's definitely not the healthiest recipe, but that's what the holidays are for. So.
Would you be able to maybe share that recipe with us?
Yeah. Yep. I have my go-to recipe. Again, it's a full day event. So you gotta like let the yeast rise, and then you have to, do all this thing, then let it sit for 2 hours. So, I'll dig up my recipe and send it. Yeah.
That sounds amazing. Yeah.
I started up on yeast a while ago because I mean, I don't think this is a thing anymore. I didn't get into the whole bread making at the beginning of quarantine, but yeast was like a hot commodity. So I have like 10 packets of yeast in my pantry.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. Well, I'm really looking forward to some of Brittany Gross's babka.
Yeah, so I'll definitely save you. I'll save you a loaf.
Thank you. Oh goodness, I'm excited. are you hoping for any special gifts this year? Anything on your list?
Not really. So my fiance and I decided to be a little untraditional this year. I think partly because Hanukkah came so quickly, and I don't know, it's somehow been a really crazy year. So we decided not to do presents this year, although I did cave and get one thing, but we are just trying to support like local businesses and shops and give back to the community as much as possible. So each night we're going to try to do something. Probably a few weeks ago, actually, we bought some art for our house from an Etsy shop. So I think tonight we'll hang that. And tomorrow we already kind of have it planned out. But tomorrow we've been craving sushi from our favorite spot. Actually in Fairmount. Don't you live in Fairmount?
Yeah, I just moved here. Yeah.
So we're getting sushi from Doma tomorrow in your neighborhood.
Oh, yeah,
that's like a treat.
I can't wait to try it.
Yeah, they don't deliver here. We're in South Philly, so it's not like really far, but we have to go pick it up, and it's like a 20-25 minute drive. So that'll be a treat tomorrow. And then maybe over the weekend, we'll just do some shopping around. We're planning for our wedding right now, so I think we're gonna like officially hire our photographer one day, and you know, just some stuff like that, give back to local artists and such.
I love that, Brittany. That's really, you know, that's when you can really feel good about this time of year. And you know, we do, I think, you know, this year hopefully has taught us that, you know, we're very, very fortunate. We're very fortunate right now. You know, I know you and I both have our jobs and we're able to work from home, and you know, a lot of the people in the restaurant industry, people that own little shops and have their own businesses, they've all been affected, and it's really nice to be able to support those less fortunate, especially right now.
It is, yeah. And my fiance and I, we both went to Drexel as undergrad, so we lived in Philly. He actually grew up here. I've lived here, you know, for the past decade, and we just love this city. We love the community. We love all the restaurants and the shops, and I mean, it's what we love about the city so much. So any way we can help support that is, you know, much more meaningful to us than buying more stuff. And to be quite honest, we have shopped a lot this year. Just, you know, I think we're all a little guilty of the online shopping. So we decided we don't really
maybe give Amazon a rest for a second. And
that was actually my number one rule. I was like, I do not want to buy anything from Amazon this holiday season. So far I think I've accomplished that, but
love that. That's a good, goal. I absolutely love that. Now, now, Brittany, let's get down to what really matters in this world right now. What cocktail is your favorite at this time of year?
Oh, yeah. So I've talked about my mom a lot on this chat, but my mom has gotten me hooked on this one drink. So it's more recent. We've been drinking it kind of for every holiday since like the summer, but I feel like it's really good because it'll, I feel like it's good for the summer. It's good for the winter. But it's called a misunderstood margarita. And it's not, it doesn't really taste like a margarita to me. I feel like that's misleading, but there is tequila in it. So I feel like that's why they call it that. But it's made with, it's called misunderstood whiskey and it's ginger infused whiskey. So I feel like the ginger kind of, to me, feels reminiscent of the holiday season, like the spices and all of that in a way. And then you mix it with blood orange juice, lime and orange liqueur and tequila and the whiskey. And then you shake it all up and it's really good. It's also like really bright and cheery looking. The color itself, it's, you know, like blood orange. So it's sort of festive in that way too.
And then when you're done drinking it, you're completely misunderstood because you can't be understood because you're slurring all your words.
We have a lot of fun. We drank that like way too much over Thanksgiving and it was a good time.
I love that. So I want some babka and I want some misunderstood margaritas. That's what sounds like a party to me.
Yeah. I'll follow up with the recipes, but I'll definitely have to, when quarantine's all over, have you over again. I know the dog Riley would love to hang out with you again and we'll have some margaritas and babka together.
Oh, that sounds so wonderful. And I just want to tell all the viewers out there, all my legions of viewers that, Brittany has the cutest little dog named Riley, and I got to meet Riley a few weeks ago. We did like kind of a little drive-by. We were socially distanced. It was very responsible, but I got to play with Riley a little bit. It was kind of like the highlight of my probably week, if not month. So yes.
She tends to do that. She's a good dog. Yeah.
She's a good baby. Is she going to celebrate Hanukkah at all?
Yeah, she did last week already. Obviously we got her, you know, new bones and she's the only one we've shopped for presents for so far, but, we'll see. I'm sure we'll end up getting her some more stuff, but
she's a good girl.
Yeah, she is.
Well, Brittany, this has been just a delight. My stomach is growling. My taste buds are just alive. And you are an absolute joy. Happy, happy Hanukkah. I'm so happy to know you.
Yeah,
and
you too.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. This was such a fun way to kick it off because Hanukkah always creeps up on you. And, you know, it's hard to sort of make a big deal of it, especially when it starts during the week. So this was a treat for me too.
Well, good. And enjoy. And I hope that you and your lovely fiance have a great time. Have fun this weekend and enjoy that sushi.
Thanks, Maddie. Talk to you soon. Hanukkah, come lie at the menorah. Let's have a party. We'll all dance the hora. Gather round the table. We'll give you a treat. Dreidels to play with and latkes to eat. And while we are dancing, the candles are burning low. One for each night. They shared a sweet light to remind us of days long ago. One for each night.